Now that we've prepared ourselves to worship, the Spirit can begin to lead us in expressing that worship in the way that would please God most. And one of the first things the Holy Spirit desires to lead us into is the very embrace of the Father. For as the Word says, we have been given the Spirit of Sonship and can cry, Abba Father. In our day, that would be like saying, Papa God. Now that's not irreverence, that's intimacy with the Father. He desires for us to be as little children, crawl upon His lap and say, Abba Father. One of the acts of worship that pleases Him most is when we call to mind different attributes of His character with praise, like His power, His mercy, His holiness. He has revealed Himself as Jehovah Shammah, the God whose presence is with us, as Jehovah Shalom, the God who is our peace, as Jehovah Rophe, the Lord who heals us. And He wants us to acknowledge who He is as we worship.
You are my righteousness.
I, John, your brother and companion in the suffering and kingdom and patient endurance that are ours in Jesus, was on the island of Patmos because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. On the Lord's day I was in the Spirit, and I heard behind me a voice like a trumpet. I turned around to see the voice that was speaking to me, And when I turned, I saw 7 golden lampstands, and among the lampstands was someone like a son of man, dressed in a robe reaching down to his feet, and with a golden sash around his chest. His head and hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were like blazing fire. His feet were like brass glowing in a furnace, and his voice was like the sound of rushing waters. His face was like the sun shining in all its brilliance. And I looked, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. And encircling the throne was a rainbow, resembling an emerald. Surrounding the throne were 24 other thrones, and seated on them were 24 elders. And they were dressed in white and had crowns of gold on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning, rumblings, and peals of thunder. And before the throne, 7 lamps were blazing, and there was a sea of glass, clear as crystal. And then I saw on the right hand of him who sat on the throne, a scroll with writing on both sides and sealed with 7 seals. And I saw a mighty angel proclaiming in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to break the seals and open the scroll?" But no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth could open the scroll or even look inside it. But then one of the elders said to me, "Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed. He is able to open the scroll and its 7 seals." And I beheld in the midst of the throne a lamb as it has been slain. And 24 elders fell down before the lamb and sang a new song, saying, "You are worthy, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth." And then I looked and heard the voice of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice they sang, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise." I saw a sea of glass mingled with fire. And those that were victorious sang the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb. "Great and marvelous are your deeds, Lord God Almighty. Just and true are your ways, King of the ages. Who will not fear you, O Lord, and bring glory to your name? For you alone are holy. All nations will come and worship before you." And then I saw heaven standing open, and there before me was a white horse, whose rider is called Faithful and True. With justice he judges and makes war, and his eyes are like blazing fire. On his head are many crowns. He has a name written on him that no one but he himself knows. His name is the Word of God. The armies of heaven were following him, riding on white horses and dressed in fine linen, white and clean. Out of his mouth comes a sharp sword with which to strike down the nations. He will rule them with a rod of iron. He treads the winepress of the fury of the wrath of God Almighty. And on his robe and on his thigh he has this name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Thank you. like a great multitude, like the roar of rushing waters shouting, Hallelujah, for the Lord God Almighty reigns. Let us be glad and give him glory, for behold, he is coming soon. And the Spirit and the Bride say, Come. And let him who hears say, Come. Even so, come, Lord Jesus.